Hi, my name is Emily Fowler, and I'm from First Assembly of God in Greencastle. Today, I will be portraying Mary Magdalene. The script is written by Stephanie Thompson and used with permission. I was broken. I had lost my grip on reality. My mind was cluttered with the word mind and voices that confused, berated, and crippled me. When I tried to grasp reality, it always seemed to slip through my fingers. There were lies, so many lies. And unfortunately, I believed every one of them. About myself and about Jehovah. But then one day, Jesus came into my darkness, silencing all the liars. His voice was so beautiful, and his authority so complete. Suddenly, the voices in my mind quieted, and my grip on reality was restored. Now I know how our ancestor David felt when he wrote the Psalms. He drew me up from the pit of destruction, out of the miry bog, and set my feet upon a rock, making my steps secure. From that day forward, Jesus became my rock. I clung to him and could not let go. I joined the group of faithful women who traveled with him at Congress as he ministered to the masses. He allowed me, a former ranting lunatic, to join his ministry, but not just as a servant, but as one of his fellow. He allowed us women to hear his teachings and learn from him. He didn't discount our value. To him, we were worth his time and attention. And then, that horrible day, they mocked him, beat him, ridiculed him, cursed him. They made him endure the choke of a trial and convinced Pilate to condemn him to death. All the while, we, the women, could not leave him. We followed behind and we watched. Oh, how my heart ached! He was so meek, so gentle. I knew his power. He cast seven demons out. And those demons knew his authority. With just a spoken word, he gave me to cower and flee. But as I watched, I recognized that he willingly endured every moment. Why? Why would he let them? When he breathed his last breath, my heart really broke. And we left in tears. The next day was Passover, and we refused to break Jehovah's law. So we participated, although half-heartedly. During this time, we also planned. We, the women who had cared for his physical needs, such as food and shelter, to care for his body as a final act of love and service. The next day, we rose, gathered our supplies, and set out for the tomb. I was shocked to see the stone had been rolled away. I heard the voice of an angel, but didn't quite grasp the words. All that I knew was that the tomb was empty. He was gone. It's funny now, I guess, but in my confusion, I thought someone had stolen his body. I confronted who I thought was the gardener until he spoke my name. Mary. Joy, sheer joy. My heart nearly leapt with rejoicing. Here he was. Death could not defeat him. The grave could not contain him. He is the stone the builders rejected. He is my rock, my fortress. He is my salvation.